I'm going to show you how to sharpen your footage in After Effects using a blur. This original tutorial I learned from Piximperfect for Photoshop, and I brought it over into After Effects, and I'm also showing you how to take a technique used in astrophotography to make it work even better. Let's dive in. Let's take a look at the results from this sharpening filter. Here is the original footage blown up to 800%. Take a look at the original filter that comes in After Effects. The Sharpen filter does work, but it gives you some digital noise and it's just not very pretty or effective. Now take a look at the sharpening technique with one pass. You can see already a great improvement in the quality and the sharpening. Now take a look at a four pass. This is the same filter stacked four times. This has a lot less digital banding and additional artifacts, and the sharpening looks really good here. Now let's go into After Effects and take a look how we can achieve this. Here we are in After Effects. Bring in your footage and duplicate it two times. Next, the top layer, let's add an invert. Then we're gonna add a Gaussian blur. Make the blurriness of the Gaussian blur 2. That top layer where you put the two effects, you're gonna go to blend mode, vivid light. Take a look at how the invert affects the footage. Depending on your footage and the desired effect, here you can manipulate it by changing the order of the invert in the Gaussian blur. It makes the footage a little bit different, so you can play around with the results. Now we're going to create the four times stack, and for our sanity, we're going to change the color labeling of these layers so we don't get extremely confused about what we're doing. So duplicate and relabel the footage with a different color to keep everything on track. Great. From here, let's make the values of the blur increase on our four stack from 2, 4, 6, and 8. Next, take the pair of the regular footage and the manipulated footage, and we're gonna group those in a pre-comp. The footage is getting there. We are close to the finish line. Now let's take our pre-comps and change the blending mode to overlay. There we go. We now have an effect that is affecting our footage at the bottom with these four manipulation layers, but it's really strong. The beauty of this technique is now we can go in and fine tune it. Let's manipulate it by selecting all of the layers, hitting opacity T, and bringing it down. We can really fine tune how much of an effect we want on our original layer. We are looking good. I want to now change the order, and it's also something you can play around with, that I want to have the ascending order, that the first blur is 2, the next blur is 4, then the next blur is 6, and the last blur is 8. And there we go. You have now learned how to do an amazing blur sharpen technique within After Effects on your footage. It is going to take your footage to the next level. If it's blurry, you can really adjust and save a lot of footage that's going to work way better than a lot of filters out there, including the one that comes within After Effects. And there you have it. This is obviously not the most straightforward tutorial. It's quite convoluted, but once you do it more and more, it gets pretty second nature, and the effects are incredible. You're not going to get the same results with the built-in Sharpen filter. So if you have footage that you got to save, this is a great way to try to reel back some of that blurriness and add some true sharpness without diluting your footage. If you got something out of this video and it was helpful for you, give me a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button. I appreciate it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you around. Goodbye.